Hey, what's up YouTube? It's Coach Remy here. Today is my first video that I'm recording in 2021. And I got a special video for you guys today, which we're gonna be talking about a common problem that many of you may experience, which is tight hips and low back pain. And I'm gonna share with you three tips to help you overcome tight hips and to spare the low back. So without further ado, let's jump into it. For tip number one, we need to figure out what is causing your tight hips. And there could be a number of reasons why your hips may be tight. And just to name a few, could be due to an injury, which your body may create a protective mechanism or adaptation to stabilize the hips. There could be a muscle shortness issue. There could be a posture issue, maybe anterior pelvic tilt, posterior pelvic tilt. There could be maybe a femoral acetabular impingement, arthritis of the hips that could cause stiffness. But for tip number one, and to kind of sum this all up, we need to figure out what is causing your tight hips to begin with in order to correctly address the issue going forward. And that leads me into tip number two now, which is, are tight hips universally bad? So tight hips aren't necessarily always gonna be a bad thing, because remember that tightness creates stability. And if we do not have enough stability, we may get too much motion, and we may get hypermobility, and we might start going to end ranges under load, which can create some hip problems in the future. So let's use two contexts here. One where you have a gymnast where they need to be very flexible and they need to have a lot of mobility. On the other hand, use a hockey player. They need to have a balance between stability and mobility. So if their hips are too stiff, it can maybe affect their stride length, or they may just compensate through maybe their low back when they're skating. But if they do not have enough stability through their hips, they may not be able to balance correctly. And when they take a shot, they may get some energy leaks, and that could affect their power when producing a shot or even maybe making a body check. So we have to look at the context, and it's not necessarily always gonna be a bad thing, but when we identify an individual and we see that they do have tight hips, and maybe if they do have a back issue, there can be a correlation there and there can be a problem. And let's use the example of golfers. So there has been research done on professional golfers where they found that golfers who had reduced internal rotation on their lead hip, so their front hip when golfing, there was a higher incidence of low back issues with those golfers that had that restriction in hip internal rotation on the lead hip. Whereas the golfers that had good mobility through their lead hip didn't have the same incidence of back problems. So what can happen is that if your hips don't move well, that can create a compensation effect where the low back starts moving more to compensate for that stiffness at the hip joint, and the low back, the joints of the low back, the discs, they start moving more and they start taking more stress. And that can lead to the development of a low back problem over time, continuously, if we repeatedly do that and do not address that issue. So there's an incidence where, you know, there's a hip issue that we need to address. And if we don't address that tight hip issue, that can lead to a low back problem, or that may be why a low back problem developed in the first place. So the point being there is that tight hips are not universally bad, but we have to look at the context and we have to develop the right mobility and stability for the activity, sport, or whatever the individual is trying to achieve. And for my third and final tip, we have to discuss, how do you address tight hips? Well, we alluded to this earlier. You need to figure out what is causing your tight hips to begin with before we can even figure out the appropriate course of action to address what is causing your tight hips. Because, to share with you a few examples, if you have a muscle shortness issue, we may want to do some static stretches with certain muscles and dynamic stretches as well, to create a little bit more length, and that maybe create, that may lead to more, some more mobility. If you have an injury, like a disc herniation that is causing a protective mechanism, we wanna get you to a point where you're pain-free, and we wanna relax, get your nervous system down a little bit if you're a very stressed individual. That may lead to an improvement in some mobility as well. If it's more of a arthritis, capsular issue, this is where maybe you want to seek out a manual therapist, physical therapist, someone that can actually do some manual work and maybe do some corrective exercise with you to help maybe loosen that joint up if there's a actual capsular issue or arthritic issue there kind of going on. So right there, you can see that there's different approaches to different issues that may cause stiff hips. But if we do the wrong thing, and if you have tight hips and you aren't sure what is causing it, and you aren't sure what the appropriate course of action is, you could actually make things worse just by kind of winging it. So if you're really unsure about what's causing your tight hips, I would recommend you go seek out a professional, whether that's a personal trainer, a strength and conditioning coach, physical therapist, manual therapist, someone that is knowledgeable and credible with, you know, hip issues and low back pain, and that they can put together a proper assessment. They can assess you and then they can evaluate you and put together the appropriate course of action and program or plan for you to help you overcome, you know, tight hips that you may have. And that can ultimately help you spare the low back of stress long-term and improve your performance, say on a sport such as golf, if that's your goal. So that's a wrap for this video, guys. I hope you took away some useful information for overcoming tight hips, and this video does help you overcome this issue and does help you spare your low back and prevent any future back problems from developing. Now, if you have any questions, concerns, need help with anything, please be sure to leave a comment below and I'll be happy to help you out as best as I can. And with that being said, guys, I wish you all the best. Have a successful and productive day. Take care.